Bonsoir, mesdames et messieurs, et bienvenue à Museum Mcherib. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Mcherib Museums. We are pleased to host the Night of Ideas at Mcherib Museums in collaboration with the French Embassy. Now, please welcome Mr. Olivier D. Thank you so much.
Ladies and gentlemen, your excellencies, dear Hafiz, thank you for coming tonight to this evening of debates and exchange of ideas. Before saying a few words on the kind of ideas, I would like to thoroughly thank the Mcherib Museum's team. When we approached them about 2 months ago in order to organize a joint evening of debate on a variation on the 2018 theme of Power to the Imagination, with a focus on urban changes at work in Doha and Paris, they immediately said yes and made it happen in a very efficient way. Hafiz, Abdallah, Shehab, Fatimas, there are many Fatimas tonight. It's been a real pleasure to work with you. Now a few words about La Nuit des Idées, or the Night of Ideas. The goal of the Night of Ideas is to celebrate the stream of ideas between countries, cultures, topics and generations. Every year, on the same day, throughout the world, the Night of Ideas gives the opportunity to discover the latest discoveries in knowledge and arts, to listen to the ones who contribute to bring more ideas to their field, and to take part in the discussion about the many issues of our times. And since ideas know no frontier, projects of any type are welcome, and all places, whether prestigious or unexpected, are called to join the party and host original projects reflecting their own interpretation of the suggested theme. As time goes by, glimpses from the Night of Ideas will echo through social media and make the Night of Ideas a global event. Can we have the map to show them? This year again, along the general theme of power to imagination, from Los Angeles to Tokyo, through Doha, 100 events in 50 cities from 5 continents will be taking place. Power to the imagination was the phrase sprayed by the 1968 demonstrators on the walls of Paris. Half a century later, how this yearning for utopia is expressed? What is the meaning of this call to be creative in all fields, technology, economy, science, or urban planning? How do societies deal with the unthinkable, like the ice cap melting, the human gene sequencing, artificial intelligence, booming cities? Can the work of imagination help us to understand better our world today? In Doha tonight, we are very excited to celebrate the imagination displayed by urban planners in the visionary build-up of spectacular urban transformations in 2 cities, both hosting major global events in the coming years. Without further ado, I will now leave the floor to Fatima Fawzi Hassan, Director of Design at Mcherib Properties, to introduce the debate and our distinguished speakers of tonight.
Dear guests, we are truly delighted to welcome you here tonight for this panel discussions. We will shed the light today on the urban growth of the cities of Doha and Paris, looking at how different factors such as rapid urban growth and rise of mega cities, economical growth, transportation and events, sport events such as Doha 2022 and Paris 2024, how these factors have helped shaping our cities. These factors are posted for urban transformations and it sets the bar quite high for cities like Doha and Paris. architects and urban planners are encouraged to create spaces that new generation will be using, enjoying, living in and working in. These raise many questions, three of which we will be discussing today and debating. What is the main challenges facing the urban areas in the cities of Doha and Paris? How major sport events such as Paris Olympic Games 2024 and Doha FIFA World Cup 2022 factor into shaping our cities, public spaces, and how they help humanizing the cities? Tonight, our panel will be discussing and debating these three questions. It gives me a great pleasure to introduce our panel here. We have two representatives from Doha, Architect Ibrahim Jada and Dr. Adilani. Two representatives from Paris, Architect Pierre and Professor Stephen Lecters. Small introduction to Architect Ibrahim Jada. Architect Ibrahim Jada obtained his architectural degree from University of Oklahoma, USA. Ibrahim had a career path starting from the positions of the head of architectural department sections in Ministry of Municipality Affairs in the State of Qatar, and a position of a chief group of chief executive officer, the chief architect of self-owned leading architectural consultancy in the State of Qatar, AAB. Ibrahim is a director of the influential AAB and has been a key figure in the Doha-based firm Progress and Expansions to Kuala Lumpur, Manila, as well as Oman, Muscat, and Bangkok, Thailand. While he has traveled to many foreign countries, Qatar still holds a very special place of a pride in his heart. His constant travel has been allowing him to use international influences to his work, in the same time keeping the traditional Qatari architecture maintain his pride of his cultural and heritage. Our second representative is Dr. Professor Ali Maarouf. He holds a PhD and MA in architecture from University of California, Berkeley and Cairo University. Professor Ali had a teaching in many universities around the world for the last 30 years. Currently, he holds the position a head of research and development at the urban planning of the city of Doha. He published more than 95 journalists, refers paper, criteria, review, and essay, in addition to a book and many of a book chapters. He is a winner of a number of research, academic, and professional awards. Our respective speakers from Paris is the architect Pierre Hélène. He is born in 1973, is an architect trained in Paris and at Harvard. He's co-founder of a Paris-based international architecture and urban design office, TVK. Since its creation, TVK have acquired a strong reputation, ranking among the most recognized French agency. Pierre and Hélène Lecters together pursue an approach where theory and practice alternatively respond and enrich each other. Through projects, research, and writing, they have steadily produced a singular artwork, at once theory and event. Our speakers, Professor Stephen Lecters, is going to be the first to speak for our event today. He's born in 1973, is currently the debut director of urban planning at the city of Paris, graduated of HAC School of Management and of a master in urban planning. He worked previously for the Greater Paris Mass Transit Authority and was the director of urban development for the southeastern part of the Great Paris Territory. He also worked between 2014 and 2017 as a counselor for the transit at the Prime Minister's office. Please join me to welcome Professor Stephen Lester to the stage.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It's a great pleasure for me to be here today with you. We had the chance to spend a very interesting day visiting your booming city with some experts. Some of them are here close to us, and it's very challenging for us to think of how your city is developing and to compare this with delighted to speak tonight of the challenges of Greater Paris growth and how the perspective of welcoming the Olympic Games of 2024 will help us tackle a few of the questions we are facing. Maybe a few facts and figures. It can be a bit boring, but it's interesting to see what we are speaking about. The Greater Paris region is a 12 million inhabitant metropolitan area, which represents one third of the French wealth and research and development. And at the core of Greater Paris lies the city of Paris, Inner Paris, as we would call it if we were in London, which is a historic city which wants to be and to remain innovative and to adapt itself to a changing world while keeping and preserving its heritage. What are the challenges we are facing at the moment in Paris? The first and the major one is to adapt this old city to the environmental and climate challenges. How can we adapt such an old city to reduction of greenhouse emissions and to preserve biodiversity? The second one is to have a socially inclusive development where all the people, whether they are poor or rich, can find housing, can move, can have a job, and can have a happy life. The third one is to promote innovation, not to stop in some old schemes, but to have an economy which is dynamic, which takes into account the new digital challenges. The fourth one is mobility for all. How can we make people move, all the people move for their job, for their leisure, and minimizing the impacts on the environment. Housing is also a big issue for us, so that all the people can have a place to live in comfortable conditions. And the last one is, as I already mentioned, to adapt this old city to the new way of living, to the new way of working, to the new way of living. To achieve this, we have a climate action plan which aims for Paris to be a carbon neutral territory by 2050. This will imply some drastic measures to reduce by half the consumption of energy and to achieve 100% of renewable energies by 2050. At the moment, we only have 17% of renewable energy in our consumption. So this is a massive change of energy scheme. Concerning transport, Paris has the chance to have a very dense public transport system, but only at the heart of the city. When you go to the suburbs, it's very difficult to move yourself. There is congestion by car everywhere, most of the time. So the government decided to build some new metro lines, 200 kilometers of new metro lines, which shall be built by 2030, with some 70 new stations, which help achieve a shift, a major shift from private car to public transport. Here you have the map of the new lines. Okay, at the same time as we will build some new metro lines, we will progressively transform some highways from cars to give this space back to pedestrians, to cyclists, to the everyday life. Here you have an example of a highway which was built in the center of Paris in the 1960s alongside the Seine River, which is a major natural infrastructure with lots of heritage monuments. It's the core, the historic core of Paris. And this highway was shut for cars some 2 years ago and is now a very nice promenade in the center of Paris where people can have access to this piece of nature again. We also promote bicycle. France lays very far behind some most advanced countries from Northern Europe, like Germany, Netherlands, Sweden, etc. But we are determined to go faster, to promote bicycle, which represent today only 4% of everyday trips in the city of Paris. And we have the ambition to reach 10% of everyday trips in Paris in 2020. As a comparison, in Copenhagen, it is 30% of everyday trips which are made by bicycle. To achieve this, we'll build some new infrastructures. We will build 1,400 new bicycle lanes in 3 years' time, which is a very ambitious goal. And we have many schemes for people to have access to bike sharing schemes, which are called Veli, which are very popular among Paris people. So here you see some examples of bike lanes which were built taking space from the cars. You have on the right side of the picture some these bike sharing schemes, and the new bike sharing Veli scheme has 30% of electric bicycles, so that all the people, the elderly people, can use bicycles. We have a few hills in Paris, not very high hills, but a bit higher as in the Dauphin. So electrical bikes could be useful to go up on the hills. And we also have lots of measures to facilitate and promote the use of bicycle. For example, the reduction of car speed, which is a major challenge for, so that all the people can move securely in the streets. We promote the use of heritage sites, the reuse of heritage sites and their adaptation to new ways of working and living. Here you have a picture of a very interesting cement structure, rail entrepôt, I don't know how you call it, which has been turned into the biggest co-working and fab lab, innovative fab lab of the world recently, which is called Station F. F station, which is an example of the way we can reuse some old heritage sites and to make them at the foremost modern and very living areas. Another example of innovation which we want to promote is to invent some new bridges. Paris has an old tradition of bridges. We have 37 very nice old bridges, and we want to invent new ones which will welcome some other activities, but we heard this morning that you have a similar project in Doha. So here you see some very old bridges which used to have some houses and shops, and we want to invent these new bridges of tomorrow which will welcome also more life, more activities. Housing is a major challenge. We need to build some 70,000 new houses every year, and we are very careful of the target of 25% of affordable houses, so that in every part of the city, poor people can find a way to live, and so that we have a real mixed city of rich and poor people everywhere. Now, a few words about the Olympic Games. We are very happy that we will host these games in 2024, one century after the last time we hosted them in 1924. And we want to make these games sustainable and inclusive games. To achieve this aim, we have two main locations of the sport competitions. The first one will be in the center of Paris, in the historic site. Here you see, of course, the Eiffel Tower. A few of the sport games will take place right in the center, so that we can show that the center is not a dead place, but very living place, which can welcome some major modern events. And at the same time, the other competition will take place in the suburbs, where we will build where we will build some new areas which will welcome both the sportsmen, but also some new sport competition. And I think Pierre-Alain will speak of one of these sites for which he's working. And we want that all these infrastructures set a new standard for sustainable area, taking into account nature and all the needs of the newer population, since the Olympic Village will be turned into a new village for Paris people once the games are over. The games shall boost urban transformation. A few examples of that: we expect to make the Seine River, our river, of good quality to welcome some bathing competition. Today the Sep cannot swim in the river because it's dirty. And we have the ambition, thanks to the Games, to welcome some competitions in the river, and then after that the Paris people can once again have access to the river and swim in this river. Another example of the heritage which we want to get from the Games is that we will build some new sport facilities for the everyday life, so that all Paris people can have access to a sport facility within 5 minutes of walking distance. Every people must have a sport place close to their home. We want to reduce drastically the amount of wastes which are produced by the population. We have a target of zero waste. All the waste shall be recycled or reused. No waste shall be put away in 2024. We want to have bike lanes everywhere, I already spoke of that. And we want to use this opportunity to redevelop and transform the territories which are today the poorest one of the metropolitan area in the northern part of Paris, so that they have a new standard of quality. And a picture to finish. This is an example of how we want sport to be everywhere in the city. The promenade shall be used for the people to go and have sports in their everyday life. Thank you for your attention.